Yes, I think, you know, all businesses have realized that, you know, app is the way to go, or mobile is the way to go, because the penetration rates are, you know, so high. I think, you know, from a industry standpoint, there is, you know, entrepreneurs have to, you know, step up the plate and figure out how do they use this entire user base and see how they can reach out to the consumer. So if I ask you, there are, we can break it down into four different parts. We call it in the mobile ecosystem as AERM, acquisition, engagement, retention, and monetization. So now, we have seen that, you know, when people come to the app industry, they think everything is, you know, all, you know, gung-ho. But, you know, they don't really understand the technicalities behind this whole acquisition, engagement, retention, and monetization. So if there is, you know, some kind of a forum that discusses this problem in a more open manner, then, you know, it will help, it will be helpful to the entire ecosystem as such. So now, you know, you have a lot of developers building apps and wondering what happened, why isn't anybody downloading it, why am I not making money out of it, you know, is mobile a fad? Now, you know, there should be a, you know, a concentrated effort that should go into sensitizing developers on these factors. So, you know, you don't need such sensitization for larger brands, because, you know, they can always use their reach, their marketing power and their muscle power, you know, their financial muscle power to do something. But, you know, this is more for the smaller developers, you know, those who are setting out into the app space. What are these main areas, and, you know, what should they measure themselves against, you know, compared to the global standard? So as we see, you know, there are, you know, several areas where mobile has already proven successful in the Western context or in the Chinese context. So, you know, we have assessed some set templates. There will always be India specific innovation, but, you know, people need to figure out and, you know, tell these people, hey, look, are you on the right track? Otherwise people won't really know whether they are on the right track or on the wrong track if there is no way to convey to them that, hey, look, you know, these are the measures. So, yeah, there are always two things, you know. One is the actual idea itself, okay, you know. What is this idea? Is it solving a problem? Is it reducing the friction for the end user, you know, and the end user, you know, that is their customers. So people have to really understand what is the demographic that they are targeting, what is the age group, what is the geography, are they targeting an Indian audience or a Western, you know, a global audience, the second thing. If they are, you know, targeting an Indian audience, you know, what is it, you know, is it tier one, metro cities, or, you know, is it a tier two, tier three things? So anybody who gets into this space should be very, very clear where his market is. Generally, it is very easy to look at the fact that, oh, there will be, you know, 400 million smartphone users in the country. But reaching out to 400 million users is very difficult. So it always helps a lot if the people who build these apps are very focused in understanding what the need that they are trying to solve. What is the user problem that they are trying to solve? What is the pain point that they are trying to solve? And for whom? So that is the fundamental thing that most people need to understand. They cannot say, oh, I will target it to generic. You can create a product for the mass market, but when you are trying to reach them, you should know who are the most important users to reach first. So that is the acquisition. Okay. So that, I think, is the key thing. Okay. So you can build products on innovation. Okay. You know something about a technology. Okay, you have built the, you know, most efficient algorithm to process videos. That's an innovation. Okay, he can build a good product, but, you know, he should also know who will it be used by. Will it be used by a college teen audience? Will it be used by a specific industry? Will the product go directly to the consumer, or, you know, do I have to sell it to the business? So, you know, these are some of the areas that, you know, users need to understand. Second thing is, you know, usability. Okay, people need to figure out, you know, on the mobile, it's very easy for a user to get distracted. So when they build an app, they should figure out, okay, you know, how do I retain the user for the first 5 seconds? How do I retain him for the first 30 seconds? How do I retain him for the first 3 minutes? And how do I bring him back, you know, as often as I can? So if you're building a taxi booking app, you know, the user will not come often. But if you're building a game app, you know, the user will come back often. If you're building a camera app, you know, probably the user will use it more when he is in outdoors. So people have to, the developers have to understand what is it that they are building, and, you know, figure out the engagement model and the model for their respective customers.